Hello, I hope you're doing fantastic. Of course, you know, we're here to learn about programming and electronics. And for several reasons we've previously discussed, we've chosen to use an Arduino board as the tool to help us learn. Specifically, we've chosen the Arduino Uno as the Arduino board to learn on. Now, the Uno, it's really the baseline Arduino board. It's the footprint that other boards are designed around, and it's really a great place for us to start digging in, and it's a fantastic launch pad if we want to move on to other platforms. So in this lesson, we're going to be doing an overview of the Arduino Uno hardware. Specifically, in this lesson, we'll be talking about the overall concept of the Arduino board. We'll talk about the three different pin header rows, the digital, analog, and power. We'll talk about some other miscellaneous things that are handy to know. And finally, we'll talk about a really handy technique for barefoot skiing. For this lesson, I recommend holding your Arduino board in your hand and pausing the video to take a look at your specific board as we discuss the different parts. You might want to hold it close to your heart and kind of rock it in your arms as we go along. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the board. The first thing I want to point out is the integrated circuit that is the brains behind the Arduino board. Very likely, it's the Atmel ATmega328, and this is an 8-bit microcontroller. So right now, don't worry about that fancy name. At the moment, it doesn't matter in the least bit. But what does matter is understanding that everything on the Arduino board is meant to support that integrated circuit. So the Arduino exists to make it easy to use this microcontroller. Now, if you look closely at the microcontroller, and it may look slightly different depending on the model of Uno you have, it may be really small, called a surface mount component, or it may be a big one like this one, called a DIP. Now, if you look closely, either casing is going to have little metal prongs that stick out of the side. And these are called pins. And these pins are how the microcontroller is able to do stuff. The pins are how the microcontroller is able to interface with other hardware and circuitry like LEDs or sensors and even your computer, as you'll soon find out. So we know that these pins are important, but the question becomes, how do we use them? How do we actually connect anything to them? And that's where the pin headers come in. So pin headers, or just headers, are those plastic rows of holes that stick up from the Arduino board. They're all along the border. And inside these holes are these little metal clips. And when you stick a wire down in the hole, like the wire that comes out of an LED or a resistor, and those are called leads, by the way, the wire will actually stick in there and it will make an electric contact. So the metal clamp inside those little plastic headers, they clamp onto the wire and it makes an electrical connection between that wire and a specific pin on the microcontroller. Now, there's three separate categories of headers, but the first ones we'll look at are the digital pin headers. The digital pin headers make up the longest row on the Arduino board, and they're numbered from 0 to 13, so that makes a total of 14 digital pins that we can use. So what do I mean by digital pins? It sounds a little abstract, so let's just try to make it as practical as possible. For our purposes, when I say digital, I mean something that's a discrete state. Let's use color as an analogy. When we're saying something's digital, it would be either black or white. So any point of gray in between, digital doesn't care about. It cares only about the black or the white. So these digital pins, they can be used in one of two ways. They can be used as inputs, and that's when they're going to read voltage. Or they can be used as outputs, and that's when they can apply voltage. When they operate as an input, they only read two different voltage states, either high or low. And when they act as outputs, they only output two voltage states, either 5 volts, which is called a high, or 0 volts, which is called a low. Now, there is an exception to this. You'll notice that some of these pins have a little squiggly mark next to them. There should be 6 of them at pins 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, and 11. And these are pins where you can use a technique called pulse width modulation, or PWM. Now, PWM is a technique that we'll learn about that allows us to use digital pins appear as though they were outputting a varying amount of voltage. Now, we'll get into PWM in much greater depth, but I just want to point out those PWM pins now. There's two other pins that I want to point out, and those are pins 0 and 1. notice they have a TX and an RX next to them with these little arrows. So that stands for transmit and receive. And these are the pins that the Arduino uses to communicate between the computer when maybe you're uploading a sketch, for example, or you're doing serial communication between the Arduino and the computer. Now, we'll be learning all about serial communication later in the course, but just a good thing to know up front is that it's best to reserve pins 0 and 1 when you run out of using all the other pins. And that's because if you add additional circuitry to these pins, sometimes it can interfere with serial communication. So this will make a little more sense as we get into the course, but for now, just kind of stick that away as a good rule of thumb. To go along with pins 0 and 1, there's also two onboard LEDs labeled TX and RX, and these will blink every time you're sending information back and forth between the Arduino and the computer. So if you've got your Arduino hooked up and they're supposed to be communicating and you don't see these LEDs blinking, that's probably a good indication that you don't have the Arduino set up correctly in the Arduino IDE and that communication is not taking place. Now, pin 13 is also worth talking about just shortly here. That's where there is an onboard LED attached, and you can use that LED as though it were externally connected through a resistor to the Arduino. The next set of headers that we'll talk about are the analog pin headers. And these are labeled A0 through A5, making for 6 analog pins. And as you might have guessed, A stands for analog. So we already said that digital means discrete states, either high or low, 1 or 0, black or white. Well, analog, it's a whole lot more colorful. So when we say something's analog, it means that it can be in any number of states. Analog embraces all of that gray space between the black and the white. So many of the sensors that you can use and will use, they create analog signals. They're not just on or off, but they're all the states in between. But for our integrated circuit, all it really knows is discrete digital states. So the way a microcontroller handles analog inputs is by using a tool called an analog to digital converter, or simply an ADC. And the ADC, it's part of the integrated circuit. It's actually built into the chip. And these analog pins, they have access to it. So what the ADC does is it takes all the variation in an analog signal, and then it cuts it up into these discrete steps. In addition to being able to use the ADC, the analog pins can also act just as digital inputs or outputs like the other digital pins we talked about. So they're pretty versatile, and we'll go in depth on how we're able to do that later in the course. So the last row of pin headers I want to talk about is the power header row. And these are just, there's only a handful of pins that I want to point out right now. So the first one is labeled 5V, and that stands for 5 volts. So if you have the Arduino hooked up to the computer via USB, or if you have external battery power applied, then this pin can provide 5 volts to a circuit. And we'll be using this pin extensively throughout the course when we're setting up our circuits. The pin next to it is labeled 3.3V, which stands for 3.3 volts. And as you might guess, it provides 3.3 volts to the circuit. Now, next to these pins are two pins labeled GND, which stands for ground. And these pins give us access to the lowest voltage on the Arduino board, which is 0 volts. Now, there's another ground pin, and it's up next to the digital pins. And what's important to keep in mind is that all these ground pins are one and the same. They're all connected to each other. So throughout the course for setting up circuits, it doesn't matter which one you decide to use in the circuits. One final note about the pin headers. You may hear a term thrown around called the Arduino footprint. So the Arduino footprint, it's simply how the Arduino headers are aligned. So if something matches the quote-unquote Arduino footprint, it means that it has that same header layout. And the most common example would be an Arduino shield, because by default, the headers on a shield are almost always going to match the Arduino footprint. Now, it's not really that important to know, but it doesn't hurt to kind of understand that if you hear that term. So let's finish up our discussion with some other miscellaneous things. There is a reset button on the Arduino board, and just like the name implies, when you press that button, the program that is currently running on your Arduino board will start back at the beginning. It doesn't erase the program, it just starts the program over. Now there's also a reset pin on the Arduino, and if you apply a low voltage to that pin, it will do the same thing as though you just pressed the button. It will reset the current program that is running on the Arduino. Now there's also a power on LED, And that power on LED, it's illuminated anytime power is being applied to the Arduino, either through a USB cable or through an external power jack. So just to sum up what we talked about kind of the overall concept of the Arduino board, that the Arduino board is built to support the integrated circuit. We talked about the three different pin header rows, which are the digital pins, the analog, and then the power. And finally, we talked about some miscellaneous stuff on the board, like the reset button, the reset pin, and the power on LED. All right, well, you probably have a lot of questions still, and that's okay. That makes sense. We just did, you know, pretty much an overview of the Arduino hardware. As we move on into the course, we'll get more in depth on some of these, on the specifics here. All right, look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye.